What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Nation Fusion, and welcome back to the channel. Hope everybody's having a fantastic day. Today I'm here to talk to you about a game called GTFO, and we can all understand what that stands for and the, you know, amazing wisdom of YouTube. We're going to refrain from exactly saying what that is, but GTFO is a first-person shooter horror survival game set in a multiplayer universe. It's got an interesting premise behind it. This is an early access title or beta review, so everything here is subject to change, and in fact this game does change pretty frequently. It's come quite a long way since I picked up my review key. So let me talk to you a little bit about GTFO and kind of what it is and kind of the concepts behind it, because it's slightly different. It's not completely different. It's not rewriting the shooter horror genre, but it is doing some things interestingly enough to set itself aside from other games. And I kind of wanted to just take a second and kind of talk to you guys about that and cover the title. So GTFO is a interesting concept. It is a four-player co-op survival horror shooter, and the premise is you go in this kind of scheduled linear transition called the rundown. And basically what the rundown is individual levels, and then every time you complete a level horizontally across, you're able to unlock after you complete the levels in that section. You're able to go deeper into the rundown. The deeper you go, the harder it gets, is the kind of concept here. And I like it. It definitely has a lot of interesting ways to tackle this. So you've got stealth mechanics, you've got shooting, and you're always kind of under-geared and underpowered to handle exactly what's happening inside of the rundown or inside of this facility. And that's the thing we're going to talk about next, is it's AI, I don't want to call them zombies, it's infected, whatever you want to call them. It's bad guys. Basically how it works is you are one of four prisoners sent down into the rundown to complete different variable objectives. Sometimes you're collecting hard drives, sometimes you're collecting data, sometimes you're getting to an area and scanning. But what's interesting is it's semi-progressive. So you start out, you go into the rundown, let's say you're doing level A1. Once you complete level A1, you're done. You don't have to run that again, but you can if you'd like. You move on to A2 and then A3, and then you go down a floor. Now you're on B1, B2, B3, now you're on C1, C2. Maybe that only C has only two. But if you die, you have to start that particular level all over. So you don't start the entire rundown, but you do have to start whatever level that you didn't complete from the beginning. So let's say you get into the you know, one of the deeper, harder missions, and it's a long one. You got to, you know, grind through a lot of different areas, unlocking doors, getting past traps, getting past enemies, that kind of thing. And you die, you got to start over. And that breeds a little bit more intensity and planning that a lot of other horror games in the genre kind of miss. If you die in other games, you either, you know, respawn, or you have to wait for your team and then your team respawns at a checkpoint, or you know, you lose some gear, whatever. Here there is no like set gear as far as like procedural. I thought that might be interesting to do, like your gear, maybe like a set of starting gear by default, but maybe when you're in these levels, finding gear that you can collect and or lose while you play. But it does have a little bit of that, you know, kind of survival element-y type thing to it. And it does it quite well. The atmosphere is pretty scary. My first kind of major complaints come from just really the production quality. And I think that will get better over time. When this game originally launched, it didn't have like animations in there, and the sound effects weren't synced up properly to the weapons, and the weapons looked a little clunky and that kind of thing. There's still a few of those problems here, but now there's some reload animations in there. It makes the gameplay just feel a little better. There is, you know, some nice lighting with fog and everything. You're going to be seeing some gameplay here in the background cranked all the way up. So you do have a good presentation, but really for me, the infected are kind of uninspiring in their design, but they're kind of cool in what they do. So what really kind of sets GTFO's bad guys out from other survival horror style games is they can't see. They're completely blind, and the only way that they can see you is by doing what players and people in the game call pulsing. So they'll make like weird croaking noises, and their heartbeats will pulse, and if you're moving during that time, they can sense that and spot you. Otherwise, you're kind of free to move out. You can get all the way, stand up right next to them, and they can't see you unless you move while they're pulsing. There are a couple of exceptions to this. There is a tentacle style thing. I believe it's called like a watcher or a scout or something. But basically, it crawls around. It cannot see either, but it unleashes tentacles. And if the tentacles touch you, it alerts all of the zombies or infected in that area. And then you pursue to have a firefight. And there comes another complaint for me. So the firefights in this game, they really lack punch. The guns just... You can't really tell when you're shooting and when you're running out of ammo. So it doesn't have like a tactile type of feedback that some other gun or games give you with the gun punch. Shotguns aren't so bad, but really the rifles and the pistols just kind of feel odd to shoot, almost like they're water guns or BB guns, that kind of thing. They still do the appropriate amount of damage. I'm just saying that the response and the feedback that you get visually just doesn't give you that kind of weighty feeling that you feel like a game like this should have. That being said, they're not terrible. They're a lot better than a lot of the other games that I've seen come out in this genre, so I don't want to ding them too much on that, but that was one of the big complaints, is just the combat feels a little awkward there. Melee combat doesn't feel as bad. It's got some punch, some good sound effects, things like that, able to charge your hits and those kind of things. So that's pretty cool. Overall, the game is fun to play. Like I said, it kind of breeds a little more intensity, considering if you die, you have to start all over. And with that, I want to talk about some of the external things. So the game is on sale right now. I believe it's a little overpriced for really the content that you get, but the developers definitely are trying their best to deliver upon that price tag. So you'll see the rundown switch, so different rooms and different procedurally generated areas. You do have some cool mechanics in the game, such as, you know, health packs, ammo kits that are able to be distributed among your team, as well as an interactive terminal. It's like a whole kind of hacking mini game inside. So if combat isn't your thing, you can always shine out as somebody who's good at doing the terminals. The terminals are used to locate items in the game, so if you're looking for a hard drive, you'll use a terminal to figure out where that hard drive is in the section of the facility that you're playing in. So it does have some cool aspects and some meta type gaming to it. One of the other things is they just recently added a matchmaking, but really not a whole lot of people use it, and it's kind of one of the downfalls to this game is they didn't come out with a stable matchmake system. They basically recruited every single person that plays the game into their Discord. So they have this Discord with this massive amount of like voice channels. So if you want to find, you know, a game, you're more likely to find a game by going into their Discord, putting in like a World of Warcraft style party message, like looking for one member, run down A2 or A1 or whatever, or looking for group there, then you already actually use their matchmaking system, which I didn't really like. I don't prefer to run Discord while I'm playing games with like an overlay. I really don't prefer to be in somebody else's Discord and say something or do something that may be against the rules, or, you know, whatever the case may be. I just want to be able to distance myself from that community Discord, and you really can't if you want to play this game with, you know, three people. So with that said, I do like GTFO. I think you guys should give it a chance if you got the spare money. I know it's pandemic going on right now, but if you're looking for a game to play in your pandemic time, this might be the one for you to check out. Again, some gameplay in the background. I hope you guys like that. If you did, leave a thumbs up on the video. If you didn't, hit the thumbs down button and tell me to kill myself in the comments down below, and we'll definitely see what we can do about that. Thank you guys again so much for watching. We'll see you next time here on Nation Fusion TV.